All right, I think I realized in that last demonstration I'd been a little sloppy about how I captured data. That is something to watch for with spreadsheets. It is easy to make a mistake because the fill cursor lets you populate fields so quickly. It's always a good idea to go back over your data and use the left arrow or the right arrow, the up and the down arrow, to make sure that your references, your cell references, which you can see here, are correct. That's important, and it's certainly one of the criticisms of spreadsheet overusage that you hear quite frequently, is that it's easy to make a mistake and to make a runtime error that in itself is not caught in your own computation. So, but anyway, we've populated this basic spreadsheet. Let's take a look at the finished product, and we can see where we're going. Here, I'm using some statistical formulas for standard deviation of population, and an F-test. But I'm not going to concentrate on those formulas right now. What I want to do is show you the type of graphs and the graphing process that you can create for yourself in a spreadsheet. So let's pretend that we want to graph the user scores over time. By the way, it's always a good idea to bold your headings. Bold your headings by clicking on B. Yes. And what we want to do is take all of the users, and then we're going to take all of their scores, and we're going to click on the graph, and here we've started to create a chart. Now, this is an important chart. You can see with three users it scales quite well, and it gives us an idea of how each user does on all 10 of their tests, okay? But if we like, we can choose other formats to look at this data in. So, for example, a line format. Now, that's a bit busy because we're trying to follow an individual user through all his various scores. So, let's stick with the column format. All right, and we'll go next, and here we can choose the defaults if our chart looks useful to us. Defaults, and I'll leave the titles and subtitles up to you. And here we have a finished Excel chart. Now, or excuse me, OpenOffice chart. So we can drag this chart down, and we can get a good look at user data here. Alright? Now, if you click on the objects in this chart, you will get various data points that you can insert trend lines, insert mean value lines, etc. So let's create another chart where that might be useful. So what I'm going to do here is select the user 1 and his heading, and then his scores. Now I'm going to create a chart just for user 1 from this. Okay, there we see user 1 and all his scores. Let's move on. Plenty of options here, but I'll let you explore them. What I most want to get you to see, is the ability to use trend lines and data lines to understand data. Okay, so here we have user 1's scores over the 10 tests. So what we're going to do is click on it till I get the nice little dots to appear. There we go. Okay, now I have all the data points selected, and I can insert a trend line. All right, the choice I'm getting here for a trend line is linear. We'll choose we'll show the equation. We'll choose linear. All right, and then I'm also going to insert a mean value line. All right, now I can move the trend equation. I can move it far enough that it's not bothering. Okay. Why might this be important? All right. So what we're going to do, let's drag this down. Oops. Sorry. Let's drag this down. And let's put this side by side with another user. All right. So we'll do this chart for user 2. And we'll get user 2's scores. Or rather, a simpler way to do this would be user 1. Then we'll select the scores. Then we'll select his scores. And then we'll create a chart for user 2. Here's our user 2 chart. Onward we go. Onward we go. Finish. Select the data points. Insert a trend line. Type linear. We'll show the equation. Okay. And then we'll insert a mean value line. Alrighty. So we've created a trend line and a mean value line for user 1 and user 2. And we're going to take a look here. If I can select this function, this equation, to get it out of the way. Okay, there we go. We're going to take a look here at the difference between user 1 and user 2. Both users have gone through your course. They've taken your 10 quizzes or tests. But it looks like user 2 is, despite a very low score here, is improving his scores. And his mean looks to be a little higher than user 1. And we can verify that by looking at the... here we have the median. We don't have the mean. So let's insert a column. Nope. Yes, we have median and average, which are the same thing, unfortunately. So let's change the median column. Nope, that's what we want. This is, an average is a mean, so we're okay here. So we'll just rename this mean to make it a little more clear with what the charts were producing. So here we have user 1 and user 2. We can see that user 2 is improving on his scores. But we want a little more data than this. What we want to know is, what are all the users doing? All right, now, I've limited myself to 3 users here, but let's create a user called all user. Okay, since again, we can select this and spread things out a little bit. All right, all user, and... all users will have the sum total scores of all the tests. So we'll put type in sum. And we'll go to the fill cursor and drag all the way across. And then we'll take these relative references for and drag them down. Okay. We select all user. We select the scores. Again, we create another chart. Yes. Next, and finish. I find the points. I add my trend line. Show the equation. I add my mean. All right, now I have a chart which I can compare to any other user. Some mouse control required here. And then we'll select this equation. Now I have 3 charts which I can compare to see how my user is progressing in comparison to the all users, for example. And we can see that user 2 is indeed quite doing quite well.